What's poppin', T Squad? It's your girl Keisha, and I'm here with tonight's All Tea, All Shade Love and Listing Season 2, Episode 1 Review. So we start off tonight's episode with Taylor reaching out to Jacob to see how he is, because he just left the party early and abruptly. So he tells her that they had the baby girl, which they named Sunset. That's a cute name. So they talk for a little while and they end up getting off the phone. So Sarah has an open house and Ajani and Zach come by, and they can tell that Ajani looks stressed in the face. So they ask her what's wrong, and she tells them people in their group keep pushing her to confront Andrew and she doesn't want to. And Sarah and Zach agree. They was like, you know, I don't really see the point. He's never going to admit what he did. So, and I, like I said to y'all last week's episode, I don't understand why they want her to confront him again. She already did that last season. She proved herself to be honest. So why would she continue to badger him about it? He's not going to admit it. She, you know, like, what's the point? Is it for camera time? I don't get why they want her to say something to him again. So Samantha stops by and they discuss her and Zach. She says that she's scared to move forward with him because they're friends and they do a lot of business together. And if things go awry, she doesn't want, you know, that to mess up their friendship and their business relationship. So, Sarah says that's how, you know, her and her guy met. His name is Clayton. He's a cute little white boy or whatever, and that's a little boo thing or whatever. So, Zach is upstairs talking to Alex, who looks like a carbon copy knockoff of Boris Kojo. And Zach tells Alex about him and Samantha and how he stepped to her and told her he want to try again and how he want to, you know, see if they can rekindle what they used to have. And Alex was like, I got to tell you something. He was like, I think Sam is seeing somebody and I think it's pretty serious. So Zach's standing there with the dumb face like, what the fuck you talking about, Willis? She ain't told me shit. So Alex says she hasn't mentioned any guy or anything, and Zach was like, nah. And in his confessional, he was like, she was giving him the impression that she was ready to go, like she's, you know, want to move forward with him, like she ain't mentioned nothing. And I can understand where he was coming from. Like, if me and you been talking, you know how I'm feeling. Why haven't you mentioned this guy? You know what I'm saying? Like, so I can know what's going on. That's the least that you could have did, and say, yo, I'm in something right now. I'm trying to figure this out. Give me a minute or whatever the case may be. So I understood where Zach was coming from with that. So he and her talk, and he asks her out to dinner that night so he can bring up what Alex told him. And she says, you know, that she wants to talk to him about something too. So Jacob at home pretending to take care of their baby. I don't know why in the hell they even did this thing, because it was so obvious that was a fake baby. It was a baby doll he was holding. Even when he put it in the playpen and they did a wide shot, wasn't nothing in the goddamn little pink blanket, wasn't nothing moving, you ain't heard a peep, nothing. I was like, girl, that was so stage. So his baby mama, who killed Selena, come home talking about how it's so hard to be a mom, and he's talking about how it's hard being a dad, and she was talking about how it's so hard to leave the baby just to go get her nails done. And it was such a scripted scene. And then she was like, well, let me go take care of the baby. You can tell she wasn't even holding no real baby. It was just all so scripted. So then his auntie Diamond calls him and they talk, and she steady calling his baby mama Angel, and her name is Angie, child. She is not seeing it for Selena's killer. And the auntie knows a lot of rappers and stuff like that, so she hooks him up with a meeting with Safari. So Ajani is at her home with her man Taryn, who look like a broke down version of Zach, to be honest with you. I ain't really see it for that nigga. Like, when he bent over and was kissing on her, his pants was sagging and he had on like some regular ass boxes. Like, who still wear boxes? Like, niggas nowadays wear boxer briefs. Don't nobody walk around with boxes on. And who walk around just sagging like that? Like, he like a dirty boy. He look dusty. But I mean, this Ajani, so. So they've been talking for 6 months and they're even talking about moving in together, which she's never even lived with a man. I'm like, why are you talking about moving in with somebody that you've only known 6 months, you fool? But you the same bitch that was fucking an engaged nigga and didn't give a damn. So, bye, girl. So he massages her feet with some butter. He literally went into the refrigerator, got out some butter, put it in a plastic cup, melted it, and then came back and started massaging her feet with some goddamn unsalted butter. After that, I said, Ajani, whatever comes your way, bitch, you deserve it, because you's a different type of bitch. You's a special needs bitch to let a nigga massage your feet with some butter, bitch. Your feet all sticky and slippery and shit smelling like popcorn. What in the fuck? Y'all ain't got no lotion around there? What kind of shit is going on? And the fact that he even thought that shit was sexy or cute and you let him? That says a lot about you, bitch. I don't see it for your ass no more. I don't feel sorry for you. Girl, whatever. So Zach and Samantha meet up on a little date and he confronts her on the whole Alex situation and what Alex told him that she messed with somebody else. Samantha say, why did he even say that? And so she goes on to tell him that she was talking to somebody here recently, but she kept on catching him in lies. The dude had kids that he didn't even tell her about. And then after that, she kept on catching him in lies. So she broke it off with him. But she didn't have the opportunity to tell Alex about it because she hasn't really been seeing him at the job. So he's still feeling some type of way about the whole situation. And he asks her if they move forward, is she all in? Because he's not going to be talking to her and she's talking to somebody else. I feel like I said, it was okay for him to feel some type of way, but she admitted to you what was going on. So at this point, y'all on the clean slate, let's move forward, whatever the case may be. So Eric is at a charity event that he's involved in, which helps black girls from South LA go to college, which I really love. I love that whole initiative. So Zach comes and Ajani is on her way and she texts Taylor in the car and asks, can they talk? And so they FaceTime each other. And Ajani tells her that she don't want things to be uncomfortable like it was at the last event. She don't want any awkwardness. She just wants it to be a cool night. So Taylor is like, it's not even about Andrew anymore. It's about my stance on you. I can't be the one who cares more than you care. I want you to get your confidence back. I'm trying to help you out and you're not getting it. And my thing is, why are you so invested, sis? Like, why do you care so much? Is it for camera time? Is it because you don't have no storyline outside of starting shit? Like, why do you want her to confront this man so bad? Because you want to sit back and see the show? Like, I'm not understanding this. Unless it has been more going on that we don't know about as the viewers, that he's been so-called slandering her name left and right. And I think that's what they were saying low-key, that I can understand that. If he's been talking shit about her this whole time, saying she a liar, she a lying-ass bitch, then I can understand it. Like, nigga, you're not going to keep on slandering my name. But if that's not the case, then why do y'all want her to confront him so bad? So IG said, I don't want to talk to him. And Taylor hangs up the phone on her because, you know, she's silly acting. So both girls arrive at the event. The rest of the guys are there too. Sarah brings her new man, Clayton. So they all standing around talking and you could tell that there was an age difference. Like she looked like she could have been like his older sister, some shit like that. So Clayton says he went to USC in 2017. So Taylor adds it up in her head and she was like, so that makes you like 24. Sarah, aren't you like 32? I'm like, this rude bitch here, if somebody don't pop this bitch in her mouth. So Sarah and Clayton just kind of standing there all awkwardly. And she was like, well, I'm immature, so it's fine. And I was like, that is not the answer that you give. You say, bitch, mind your beat nose business, bitch. I don't give a fuck if this nigga is damn near 10 years younger than me. I ride this dick good and he eat this pussy good. That's all the fuck that matter. The nigga is illegal, so what the fuck ever? Mind your business, bitch. At least I got a nigga. Shut the fuck up. So Sam arrives with her flat booty ass. Zach up there eyeing her as he's talking to Alex and Eric. So Sam go outside and she sit down with Ajani and she tells Ajani that Alex told Zach she was seeing somebody else. Meanwhile, we find out that she tells Ajani that she told Alex not to say nothing and that her and the dude had just stopped talking 2 weeks ago. So I'm like, okay, so you was being shiesty. You was being on some other shit because why would you tell Alex not to say nothing? Like if you ain't want Alex not to say nothing, then you shouldn't even say nothing, period. Learn how to keep your goddamn mouth shut, bitch. But my thing is, like, why wouldn't she just fess up and tell the truth? Yeah, I'm talking to somebody right now. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to figure it out. What's up with you? Like, it's always a way to finesse shit. So I didn't really understand that whole part of it. So, where was I at? Zach tells Eric the same thing about the whole situation of Alex telling him that Samantha was talking to somebody else. So Jacob meets with Safari and they bond over their, you know, them both having daughters and everything. And Safari tells him he wants to film a music video at a really dope house. And he's giving all these details of how he wants the house to look. And he tells Jacob he wants the house to resemble heaven. And he like, how the hell I'm supposed to make something look like heaven? You know what I'm saying? I ain't never been that motherfucker. What I'm supposed to ring-a-ding Tupac? So a new girl named Brittany is introduced and she spells her name B-R-I-D-N-E-Y. Never seen it spelled that way. Her name is Brittany. And she's introduced and she needed a hot oil treatment. That's all I got to say. Her hair was looking like mine, child. So she sits down, she talks to Ajani, Sam, and Sarah. So Taylor is inside and talking to the guys, and you know, she was like, who else is here? They was like, all the girls are outside. Ajani is here. So she kind of make a face, and they was like, oh Lord, what's that about? And so she was like, we got into it. I feel like this thing with Andrew, I've had her back with it. I stopped working with him because of it, and she's sweeping it under the rug. So I'm looking at her like, you're a liar. Andrew is a fraud, and now I'm looking at Ajani like she's a fraud too. My thing is, I don't believe at all that you stopped working with Andrew because of the situation with him and Ajani. I don't believe that shit at all. When I went on Taylor's Instagram page today, apparently she has now started her own real estate company. She works for herself. She don't even work with another brokerage firm. She just started some shit on her own. I'm pretty sure because people have seen her on this show and see how messy she is and how ghetto active she is, that don't nobody want to work with her ass. Jacob worked for Caldwell Banker, child. The other people on the show do work for high-profile real estate companies. However, Eric say, I talked to her again the other day about it, and about Andrew, and she's like, oh, it's good. And I'm like, why are we protecting you? And I'm like, why are y'all sitting up there gossiping about female shit, first of all? And what do you mean, why are we protecting you? Protecting you protecting her from what? And Zach say, the story just don't add up. Now he being fake, even though Earl, you know, in the other episode, and when he was around Ajani, he was up here saying, I agree, you don't need to say nothing to him. I'm like, oh, y'all some pussies. So, Ajani overhears them talking about her. So Taylor tells the guys, I defended her when she had engaged with a married man. First of all, he was engaged. Regardless, it was still wrong. She said, either you never fucked with him or you're still fucking with him. So Sam takes Ajani into the bathroom to tell her what was being said. So she tells her that Taylor thinks that she and Andrew are still messing around, and Ajani denies it. Sam say, why is she so invested? That's something we all want to know, baby. So Ajani goes to confront her, and Samantha tells her that she got her back. So they bust up in the room, child. And Ajani walk up in Taylor's face. She was like, so what was that shit you was talking? Now that I'm in your face, you can rinse and repeat that shit you was talking. I was like, rinse and repeat? So Taylor's like, I think you have no backbone. So now I'm looking at you like you are the liar. Did you really have sex with Andrew? Ajani said, you're the one perpetuating the whole story. I already let it go. Taylor saying, you let it go for what? I left working with Andrew because of the lies he said about you. Ajani said, I told my truth. And Taylor said, now you're forgiving him. And Ajani was like, yes, I'm forgiving him. I'm not like you. I let the shit go. Now, wait a minute, sis. Now, this is where I had a problem with. What the fuck you mean you forgiving him? You forgiving him for what? I mean, you can let the situation go, but ain't no way in hell I'm gonna forgive a nigga that's up here trying to make me look like I'm a liar, like I'm all on his dick and just crazy and shit. Like, nah, bitch, nah, hold up. So Sarah in her confessional say, I don't think Clayton has ever seen someone act like that. I mean, it's embarrassing. And I'm like, now hold up, bitch. You're not going to act like the black girls is ghetto. Because last season, you was at a party arguing back and forth with Taylor ass too. Now, we not about to do that, Miss Sarah girl. Because who the fuck is Clayton? Clayton, old USC, probably a mom and them paid for his ass to go to that school. Old Billy Bob, Billy Ray looking motherfucker. Old, I wore khakis and Dockers looking ass nigga. Like, he, who the fuck is he? Girl, who the fuck is he? Ain't nobody trying to impress this little motherfucking girl back. Now, you can stop with that, bitch, because you want a cast with all black folks. So we not about to do that, bitch. Let's not. Taylor say, everybody is looking at you crazy. And Samantha steps in because she feels like Taylor is going too far. She says in her confessional that Taylor got to saying some real foul shit to Ajani or whatever. So then Brittany jumps in and say, why can't you just let it go and let her live her own life? Now, my thing was, Brittany, you new to this. How are you jumping into the conversation? This ain't got nothing to do with you. Wrong time, wrong event, wrong situation. You were just wrong. Your hair was wrong. Your outfit was wrong. Everything was wrong. You should have just sat back and sipped your tea and enjoyed the festivities. She was out of line. So Ajani tells Brittany to stop. She was like, stop. Like, girl, this ain't even got nothing to do with you. Like, I just literally met you. So Taylor said, who are you? Who is this bitch? And Brittany said, call me a bitch again. And Taylor said, bitch, in her face. And I was like, okay, Taylor got a little backbone. She ain't a punk after all. Now, was I happy as hell that Brittany mushed the shit out of her and made her fall on her ass? Absolutely. because Taylor is repulsive. She is a reptile. She gets on my nerves. She looks like a pelican. She reminds me of the movie Pelican Brief. Somebody should have been slapped the shit out of her. She should have slapped her instead of mushed her ass. She deserved it. But Brittany was out of line because she shouldn't even got involved. But did Taylor deserve that? Absolutely. So Taylor jumps back up trying to get at it, but you know, she had on them Louboutins, she had on them Socates, bitch, so she couldn't even really, you know, maneuver around. So she throw her drink and she trying to get at the girl, but Zach bear hug her from behind and he escorts her out. And she's like, let me go with her old Eddie Murphy raw outfit. She thought she looked good too, bitch. That was a cute outfit though. So Ajani tells Brittany what she did was whack and this, this, and that. Brittany up there looking tall and wrong and just stupid. Taylor tries to walk back in, but Zach won't let her. And then the episode go off, child. Child, tonight's episode of Love Enlisted, I give it an A. They coming back with the drama. I'm loving it. Let's talk down below about tonight's episode, child. Let me know what y'all thought. Make sure y'all look at my P-Valley series premiere review. I did a review on the Shy Married to Medicine LA season finale. What is it? Why I put a video out today on why I will not be reviewing Black King Crew ever again. Make sure you check that out, as well as my Marriage Boot Camp Hip Hop Edition review as well. And my Love and Marriage Huntsville, Alabama review. I told y'all when I came back, I had y'all. Look at all these damn reviews y'all got to watch. Your girl, love you. Rest in peace to Naya Rivera. So sad to hear that they found her body. I loved her. I've watched her throughout her career from when she was on a Full House on to Glee. Loved her on Glee. It's so unfortunate what happened to her. I'm praying that for her son and her family and everything else that is going on. I mean, this year has just been the year from hell. Jesus Christ. It seemed like every other day is something else going on, Jesus. And I'm just like, Lord, help us all. Y'all stay safe. Keep on wearing your mask. Keep you stay your asses in the house, child, so we can get over this COVID shit so the shit can stop spreading. Spread peace and love. Black Lives Matter. All of that good shit. I love my people. I love y'all. Love y'all, love y'all, love y'all. I can tell everyone that you know that you love them. You never know. Tomorrow might not be promised. Love you. Bye.